guys. I'm really psyched you've all turned up to my leaving do. A party in memory of my heroic achievements at Chew Valley School. I'm so much better than all of you. My farts don't even stink.
This is a Christmas do, Hildrew. You'll fart horrendous.
I can second that.
Stinky farts aside, I wouldn't miss this for the world, Hildrew the Drew. My man, my main guy, my bro, my sugar daddy. Literally one of my only two friends. I'd like some more.
You old rascal, you with your weird long legs.
Well, I think they're perfect, Andy. Do you want a massage?
Personal toilet again. That's the fourth time this week and it stinks!
What are you on, Borman? You know I can't poo in school. It was probably brown.
It wasn't me, Troop, because I was at the pub.
Actually, Rob, it was me. All four times. But you know what they say, big things come in little packages.
Right, back to the main point. Here Here wants to see the rap battle of the century. Me versus Mr. Hildrew. It'd be a way of not letting go, I didn't mean to say that. It would be a way of saying goodbye. We would love to buy you a present, but we're so skint at the moment, we can't afford it. I mean... I stole these shoes from Primark.
Money, money, money.
I know I'll be there.
And we all know it ain't a rap battles if Rennans ain't rolling.
I'm going to miss you both so much. Who am I going to go frog spotting with? Or extreme ironing? Who?
Why not Mr. Langdon or Mr. James?
Well, it wouldn't be the same. All James wants to do is lick portraits of William Shakespeare and... and I don't actually understand a word Langdon says. I thought he was French when I first met him.
As it happens, Mr. Arbuckle, I have plenty to do in my spare time. When I'm not DJing on the weekends, I'm writing my new book, 50 Shades of James.
You may want to rethink the name on that one.
And on that note, I think we should start getting sloshed.
money of mine. You used to. Yeah. You used to call me on my cell phone.
I can't believe they're leaving me. It all feels so surreal. One minute you're booking a lad's trip to Vegas, and the next your two best friends tell you they're leaving the school. I haven't been this sad since Rita Ora refused to sign my bottom at one of her live concerts. I can't take this. Not after the school lost its status as outstanding. Although the sick form is still classified as outstanding. Guess who's been pulling their weight around here? Oh yes, it's me. Outstanding. But even so, oh the hardship. Why do bad things always happen to me? I'm a good person. I just don't understand why they do this to me. We could be soaring, flying. Starry, heavenly, heavenly. If we're trying, oh, we're breaking free. Yes. Yes, that's it. I'll make them love me. Then we can be together forever. And we can move to the Big Apple like we always dreamed. Just a group of guys living on the Upper East Side. Headlining Broadway in the evenings and eating cat food in the day. But how will I make them love me? I know, I'll kidnap them. It'll be totally romantic. Just me and my guys.
Yes, a loathsome individual, a person who has had quite a profound impact on the world, but some might argue not necessarily positive. He is genuinely one of my favourite human beings, and I say that with true and genuine sincerity. He's somebody that I think we were all quite glad to see the back of, but now he's ruining something else instead, so we'll leave him to it.
Well, I think he spreads hatred around anyone that sort of sees him.
Oh, I think he's a very troubled and not very clever individual, and I'm quite frightened at the prospect that he might actually take power.
I must say I'm not a fan.
Well, it's a bit of a shame that he's headed off. A lot to give in this country. Swansea City were looking for someone of his calibre.
Oh, just an idiot. Just waste of space. What's the point?
An idiot.
I don't think I know him. Should I know him? Evil, generally, very well known across the world as being a dictator, racist, generally horrible guy. Ah, he's repellent, and he's ugly, and he's got the most vile opinions. He's disgusting.
An idiot and a waste of space.
I think he's a total blend. His hair is nice, mind you.
I don't care what anyone tells you, Mark. Cat food tastes good and it's nutritious.
I couldn't agree more with you, Chris. And it's cheaper than human food too, which is good, because I bring the whole school budget on my wife's birthday presents.
What did you get her?
Oh, I got her a trip to the capital of Thailand. What's it called again?
Bangkok. So naughty, Mark. On a more serious note, do you think Andy's upset that we're leaving? I mean, the three of us do everything together. I mean, everything.
Well, I mean, yes, I think he is. I think he thinks we abandoned him. But it's not like that. He needs to move on, and so do we.
Albeit we are a big part of his life. Mm. Speaking of letting big parts of us go, I've got to go and use a cat litter, if you know what I mean. So, I'm off for a poo.
Well, I'm all alone again, aren't I? Very sad. Oh!
Andy, what are you doing?
You will understand soon, my love. You don't need to leave. We can reach together.
I'm afraid I can't let you do this, Andrew.
So be it. We shall duel. I must warn you, Chris. I am in great shape. I once took a Brazilian jiu-jitsu class when I was 12, so I do know a thing or two. Want to see me do a press-up?
Please. Well, I too have dabbled in the martial arts. You're in for a world of pain, buddy boy.
Have you had enough yet?
I ask
they've gone.
They wouldn't run away. Mark couldn't afford it.
And surely they'd have taken Mr. Arbuckle with them. Those three do everything together. I mean everything.
No, they probably just went for a walk.
Maybe someone's taken them.
Who would do it? And why?
Maybe it was the Irish one from One Direction. Ah, some look of the Irish.
Oh, anyone want a massage?
Everybody, quiet! This is getting us nowhere. We have to establish the last time they were seen.
I saw them together earlier. They were by the lunch hall, but I was too busy licking this portrait of William Shakespeare, who, might I add, is a mighty great guy.
Yeah, me too. I saw them guys walking and talking.
Didn't I see you there and earlier as well, Andy?
No. I have this thing. You know me, doing my thing. Shaking your thing.
What are you doing?
Anyway, everybody, party at my house, apart from the history department.
To quote Mahatma Gandhi, yes! Woo!
Oh, is that just happened?
No, it won't get as cool on me. Brilliant. There's a webcam, so I'm on the brilliant review.
I am as well, if I'm not careful.
Andy in the lunch hall this morning. Why on earth would he be lying to me? Unless, could he have? Surely not. He may look like a praying mantis, but he's no kidnapper.
Lindsay, these are some serious allegations. Whoopsie doopsie loopsie.
Shots on me, anyone? Anyone?
Well then you tell me what has happened, Robert. I think I may be able to prove it.
Wait a minute, where are all of the language teachers?
You're probably all wondering why I've arranged this meeting. My Snapchat was fairly secretive, but I couldn't be too careful.
Well, this better be quick, first shift at the Salt and Malt in 10 minutes. With all the budget cuts, we have to think outside the box where money's concerned. But then again, I can't really complain at £5.25 an hour.
I wish people hugged me more. Just a big old teddy bear on the inside. In fact, from here on out, I would like all students and teachers alike to call me Mr. Jamesy Wamesy.
It is important to you. I'm sure Pa will hug you, Mr. Jamesy Wamesy. Now, let's get down to business. I know what happened, Mr. Mallet and Mr. Hildrew.
What?
It was Niall, wasn't it?
No. It was Mr. Andrew Evelyn Arbuckle. He kidnapped them both, and I can prove it.
Shut the front door.
But how can you prove it, Trump?
Well, you know how Mr. Hildrew's always tweeting on that bloody phone of his?
Yeah.
I bet you all the money in the school, all £12.50 of it, that Mr. Arbuckle has that phone on him right now.
No, she's lying. Come on, guys. They were gonna leave me. They wouldn't if they loved me. I'm such a saucy minx.
So, where are they?
They're in the library. No one ever goes there as the librarian is currently in Sudan. And reading is for wieners.
I read all the time.
Wheeler!
Well, I don't know about the rest of you guys, but I think I deserve a few babies.
So, where does One Direction's Niall come into all this?
He doesn't. Ah, 'tis a four-leaf clover.
Actually, it was all Niall's idea. I knew him from my days as a bullfighter, and we still keep in touch.
Anyway, Andy, it's okay. You acted rashly, and as usual, you were really stupid. But it's okay. Now, to quote Mahatma Gandhi, why don't we go find Mallet and Hildrew and watch this rap battle?
Yeah! I think I've served myself.
Hello and welcome to the rap battle of the century.
Him being the oldest, of course.
No hard feelings, Chris. My rap persona is Hendrick Lamar. He's quite ghetto, I understand.
Well, I've got my own rap persona, Mr. Mallet. Let me introduce you to Smelly Chris.
Okay, with that terrible trash talk underway, let's get this party started.
Up, homies, get down with my crew. Give MC Hammer the respect he's due. I've been running this place for quite a few years. Won't take me long to get my mouth in gear. Chris, my friend, you are out of whack if you think you can lay me down on this track. Because you've no idea how to handle my sass. You may as well get down on your knees and kiss my law degree. Boom!
No way, Mark, you're a big old fool. How do you think you can run this school? Where's the money at, fool? You better keep an eye on tapes on notes. Like Lady C says, you're a vain old goat. You don't think you handle, you're gonna lose this bet. You can't handle me and my growth mindset.
Nice rhymes. Trash rhymes, Chris. But give way to the master. You're leaving this battle on a stretcher in plaster. Because I got the rhythm, I got the rhymes, and I've got the truths. Yeah. While my main man, Lenny, is going to bust some moves.
festive, but you can't deny that my outfit's more festive. You're gonna go down, I'm gonna tell you, I ain't no liar. I raced your chestnuts on an open fire.
To the preacher. You ought to take notes. I'm a much better teacher. Yeah.